Lord, please be with Jordan. I know he's going through a tough time in his life, but please just keep him safe.
Please spare him. Spare Jordan, Lord. Preserve his life.
He never thinks of himself, Lord. That's why he's in trouble.
Dear God, I'm fighting for Jordan, and please keep him safe.
Help Jordan, Lord. Keep him safe tonight.
Dear God, I pray that you would just have Jordan stay. I need him. He's just such a good coach.
Hello, Joseph. Trouble?
Looks like we'll have to send someone down. A lot of people asking for help for a man named Jordan Bailey.
Jordan Bailey. Yes, tonight's his crucial night. We'll have to send someone down immediately. Whose turn is it?
That's why I came to see you, sir. It's that clockmaker's turn again.
Oh, Clarence. He hasn't got his wings yet, has he?
We passed him up right along because, you know, sir, he's got the IQ of a rabbit.
Yes, but he has the faith of a child. Send for Clarence, Joseph.
You send for me, sir?
Yes, Clarence. A man down on Earth needs our help.
Splendid. Is he sick?
No, worse. He's discouraged. At exactly 2:45 p.m. Earth time, that young man will be thinking seriously of throwing his life away.
Oh dear, dear, his life. Then I have an only hour to dress.
You'll spend that hour getting acquainted with Jordan Bailey.
Sir, if I should accomplish this mission, might I perhaps win my wings? I've been waiting for over 200 years now, sir, and people are beginning to talk.
Clarence, you do a good job with Jordan Bailey, and you'll get your wings.
Oh, thank you, sir, thank you.
If you're going to help a man, you want to know something about him, don't you?
Actually, of course, I...
Now, keep your eyes open. You see the town?
Where? I don't see a thing.
Oh, I forgot. You haven't got your wings yet. Now, look, concentrate. Begin to see something?
Why, yes! This is amazing! Hey, who's that?
That's your problem. Jordan Bailey.
A kid?
That's him when he was 9. Jordan saved his brother here from a fall that would have left him crippled.
Amazing!
A few months later, another important event took place at lunchtime.
I don't really like the salad.
What? You don't want the salad? Hey, brainless. Mostly every greatest NBA player eats salad.
Oh. Well, when I grow up, I'm going to be in the NBA.
Stop!
Hey, what are you doing in here?
Wait, that's rat poison, not lemonade.
Oh my gosh. Jordan, thank you so much.
Hurry, Mrs. Kirby.
Hey, what'd you stop it for?
I want you to take a good look at that face.
Who is it?
Jordan Bailey.
Oh, you mean that boy that got hugged by that mother?
That's the kid.
Oh, it's a good face. I like it. I like Jordan Bailey. Tell me, did he ever tell anyone about the lemonade?
No, not a soul.
What happened to the little girl? Did he ever go to the NBA?
Well, wait and see.
Did my package come in for Jordan Bailey?
Yeah, your shoes are right here.
Oh, good. But these are old. I ordered the 2012 Nike Hyperdunks.
Oh, here they are.
Oh, hot dog, yes, sir. Oh, yes, now I'm ready for the NBA. Yes. Thank you, Mrs. Curry. Have a nice day.
Hey, Gabe, have you seen your buzzing shoes?
Yeah, those are pretty sweet, Doug Hoodie. I know he's going to go far in the NBA. He's obviously no match for me athletically, though. But I think I'll be a better stat taker than a player.
Is that the intern program you're talking about?
Yeah. The Golden State Warriors have this internship program where 2 lucky high school students get to travel with the team and learn how to take stats like the professionals do.
That's cool, but you do know your chances are like 1 in a million.
Yeah, but...
More like 0 in a million.
Potter, I didn't see you there.
So... Online during school hours.
I'm sorry.
That's gonna cost you.
I'm sorry, Potter.
Don't talk while I'm talking.
Sir.
Now, this is my school. Nothing goes on here without my knowing. Now get back to work.
Sir.
Yeah. He's gone.
That Potter. Singing teacher's pet. Everybody loves him except the students.
Oh, what's this?
It's a game called basketball, Clarence.
Does that have anything to do with the NBA?
Everything.
Is it the NBA?
Not exactly. It's an after-school program geared to equip younger students called the New Stars for a New Decade. It's the one program Potter doesn't have
his
hands on.
All right, hey guys, I want to thank each of you for being a part of the New Stars of the New Decade Foundation. Now, I know we've had some people come in here and try to tell us that what we're doing doesn't matter. They're trying to bring us down, trying to hinder us from what we're trying to do. But you guys know the real purpose of this foundation, and that's to help out the little guys, to help develop you guys for your future, all right? So don't worry. Don't quit and keep it up.
Oh, that's Jordan playing now. Quite skilled, is he? He'll have no trouble playing in the NBA.
You're a junior, right? So, how old are you? I'm sorry, Mary, but I gotta go.
Here, just keep it cool. I'll be back. See ya. Bye.
Sorry.
Kaw! Jordan, glad you came. I heard you were leaving. Actually, Jordan, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. You see, remember my dad, the one with cancer I told you about? He passed away this morning, Jordan. My mom, she just can't make it alone. She can't live by herself, so I'm gonna have to move to Arizona to live with her.
But what about the Stars of the New Decade?
Well, I was hoping that you would be able to take my spot.
But Kyle, you know me. I can't do that. I'm transferring from school so I can go to the NBA.
But Jordan, what about the kids?
I don't know. Someone else can do it.
Like who?
I don't know. I have my own life to worry about.
Students, I think that's all the time that we have for our meeting tonight. Jordan, I know you got a plane to catch. Good luck with your basketball training camp, and we're sure going to miss you at North Valley Baptist Schools. Now, into further matters, Mr. Potter, your proposal with the New Stars for New Decade program?
Yes. I want to state my real purpose for being here. I claim that the New Stars of a New Decade Foundation is not relevant to this school.
Now, it's too soon after Kyle's dismissal that we go talk about disbanding this foundation. He just got to take care of his widowed mother, for Pete's sake.
Yeah, Caleb, I agree with him. Potter, let's discuss this at a later time.
I'll go further than that, Mr. Nolan. I'll say that to the students, Kyle was the New Stars of the New Decade Foundation, and with him gone, so is the program.
Well, that's fine coming from you, Potter, considering that you drove him away.
Well, it's obvious that Kyle had some leniency to some of these students of the foundation.
Now, wait a minute, Potter. Maybe Kyle was so lenient with some of these kids. Why he ever started this cheap, terrible old foundation, I'll never know. But Kyle really cared for these kids. All the time he worked here, he never thought of himself.
Well, no matter. With Kyle gone and nobody to lead, it's technically mine. And that means it's dissolvement.
Now, wait a minute here. Now, none of you guys are going to take Kyle's place? You're going to let Potter tear it to the ground? Well, if no one will take, I'll do it. I'll take over the program. These kids need this. Potter, you need to learn that you can't take over every program in this school. Good day, sir.
Oh, that Potter sure likes to boss people around.
Oh, yes. He lied, stole, and pushed his way to the top at NVBS, even taking over all fundraising. Why, he became the most feared authority the student body ever elected.
That cruel bully.
Yes, and Jordan was the only one who ever stood up to him.
Tell me, what became of the new stars of a new decade?
Jordan succeeded with helping them reach their potential, as he felt he lacked his. Those kids sure loved him for it, Clarence. Some of the best behaving boys you'd ever see walking the hallways.
Oh, and what of the young lass he was courting?
They continued and fell in love.
Splendid.
Jordan's younger brother Gabe excelled in the Warriors internship, and they kept him on, touring the country and traveling with his team for the NBA.
What then of Jordan? Does he make it into a bigger school to fulfill his dream of playing in the NBA?
No. Why, he continued day in, day out, doing his best at school, running the junior high program. And then one day, Potter arranged a meeting to manipulate Jordan.
Well, thanks for coming, Jordan. Here, have a bar.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Whoa, this is quite a bar. So, what was the real reason you wanted to see me about Potter?
Now, let's say that I have contacts in the League of Professional Scouts. Let's say that I can bring them down here and have them watch you play ball.
Well, hot dog. That sounds quite fine.
Now, if you were an ordinary common old student, you wouldn't be able to get it. But Jordan Bailey is not an ordinary common old student. Wow. He is an intelligent, smart, ambitious young man who hates his job. A young man who has to watch his friends go places because he's trapped. Trapped playing nursemaid to a bunch of milk drinkers. Now, do I paint a vivid picture, or do I exaggerate?
Well, what's your point?
My point is I want to have my scouts scout you.
Well, it's kind of a rush. Will you allow me to talk it over and think about it?
Oh, sure. Go on home and talk it over with your family.
Thank you. No. I don't need to think about it. I already know my decision. I'm not gonna do it. You just think you're the biggest man in town, you know? You know, in the vast of this whole configuration, you know, you're just a little scurvy little spider, you know? Just get moving around like this, trying to trick people and get people all tied up. Yeah, I don't need to think about it. No.
Hey, Caleb, how much are we up to?
Oh, we're almost there. Just a few hundred left.
Oh, wonderful. That's really good. Yes. I'm so glad we're making good progress, you know.
Doing good.
Oh, here, let me answer this. You will make the deposit, okay? So,
you do that real quick.
Hello? Oh, Harry, how you been? When you coming down? You're not? Oh, a promotion, oh.
Hey there, Potter, Merry Christmas. You showing your magazine yet?
No, I haven't yet.
I got a copy of it right here. You see all these fellas? Once part of the new stars of the new decade, and now look at them, with their own fancy magazine and all.
You done bragging yet?
You keep this. Merry Christmas. Hey, Mrs. Kirby, I just came to drop off some money. One second, I'll be right back.
Decade.
I don't know where I put it.
You don't know where you put what?
I don't know where I put the money. I think I lost it. I know I checked everywhere.
You lost your money?
I think someone will find it.
Caleb! You know what that means?
One of us is going to be accused for stealing, and one of us is going to be expelled, and it's not going to be me!
Oh. Hi, Jordan.
Hi, Jordan.
This is my decorated tree.
Nothing's wrong.
Can you
do it? Good job. Does she keep blowing that thing?
Jordan, let's go
upstairs into the kitchen.
Excuse me,
Jordan.
What?
I burped.
Jordan, what's wrong?
Everything's wrong. Why do we have to live in this crummy old house?
Hey, Jordan, how do you spell Frankenstein?
I don't know. Ask your mom. Man, what do you think? I'm a dictionary or something? Hey, stop playing that thing. God, there's so annoying. Sorry, everybody. Yeah, Jason, JT, you can keep playing now. Yeah, cool. Go ahead, keep playing. Sorry. Oh, Potter, I'm sorry to bother you. Can I please come in? I need to see you for a minute.
Well, if it isn't Jordan Bailey. You come to me now after you turned down my generous offer.
Potter! I have a problem. Through some mistake, I misplaced $800. I need your help.
Oh yes, I've heard. The Slys are very upset.
Would you please help me? Oh, Potter, please help me. Can't you understand what this means to me and the kids? I need your help. You can have the new start of a new decade. I'll do anything, please.
Jordan, are you sure there wasn't any discrepancy in the books?
No, Potter, I just misplaced $800.
You misplaced the $800.
Yes, sir.
Now, Jordan, what have you been doing? Playing the market with the foundation's money?
No, sir.
But why are you coming to me? Why not to go to any of your other friends?
They don't have any cash. You turned them all down since you canceled the fundraising from the candy sale.
Well, now. I've certainly become quite important to you. Do you have any security, deposits, or any savings?
No, sir.
Valuables of any sort?
No, sir.
You were once so cocky. You were the big shot. Going to the NBA. You're nothing but a miserable little man with nothing to show for your life. I'll tell you what. You've got some papers right here for you to transfer to Belmont High.
Well, that's the worst school in the county.
Well, it looks like I do own everything in this school. Including you. And one more thing I'll do for you. I'm emailing Brother Azzarello and the Slys right now, informing them you acknowledge full responsibility for the missing $800.
Dear Lord, I need your help. I don't know what to do. I'm at the end of the road. I don't know any other way but to sign these papers.
Help! Help! Help!
No! Don't fall! I got you!
I got you! What were you thinking? What are you doing?
Hey, what are you doing out here? Get off a bridge like this. You can't do that.
I did it to save you.
Shame me.
I did, didn't I? I stopped you from leaving school.
Stop me from leaving school?
Yeah.
It's ridiculous of you to leave school for $800.
How'd you know about that?
I'm your guardian angel. My name's Clarence. Clarence Oddbody. Angel, second class.
Aren't you kind of like a fallen angel? You don't even have any wings.
Oh, I haven't earned my wings yet. But you can help me earn them.
Oh, sure. How do I do that?
By letting me help you.
The only way you can help me is you don't have about $800 on you, do you?
No. We don't use money in heaven.
Oh, too bad then. So why are you helping me from leaving school?
You've helped so many people, and you would let so many people down if you left.
I would help people if I just left and never existed.
I wish I never was born.
You mustn't say things like that. Oh, what? Joseph, what? Wait a minute. Good idea.
You've been granted your wish. You've never been born. Come on, I have something to show you.
What are you talking about?
Show. What did you want to show me? What happened to my junior high picture?
It never existed. You weren't there to take over for Kyle when he left for college.
What are you talking about? Mrs. Kirby probably just took it down. Hello there, Mrs. Kirby. How are you doing?
I'm sorry, who are you?
Mrs. Kirby, it's me, Jordan Bailey.
Jordan Bailey? We said yeah. Gabe Bailey, but Gabe yeah. Bailey was paralyzed.
Gabe, no, that can't be right. Hey, what about that picture of the junior high team out there?
Junior high program?
Yeah.
We haven't had one of those in years, since Potter disbanded its team.
No. Wait, what?
Watch out where you're going!
Oh, I'm sorry. Ashley!
Do I know you?
It's me, John Bailey. What are you doing cleaning up?
This is my job. I don't need more whack jobs like you messing it up for me.
You're, the poison. Your mom. What happened?
You don't need to bring that up.
I'm sorry, Ashley. Jordan.
You. What's going on here? Why does everyone remember me?
I told you, you were never born.
Oh, no, that's not it. You're a hypnotist or something.
You really believe that?
Yeah. What? Why is Gabe crippled, and what happened to Ashlyn?
Ashlyn has to pay for her own school bill because her mom, you never stopped her from poisoning that lemonade. She got charged for manslaughter.
And what about Gabe?
He fell down those stairs. You were never there to save him.
Well, where's Mary?
I can't say.
Where's Mary?
She's a drink and all the drink left.
Mary!
I'm sorry, do I know you?
What are you talking about? It's me, Jordan Bailey.
I don't know who you are.
Mary! Mary!
Wait, what's going on over here?
No, it's me.
Who are you?
Mary.
Jordan Bailey. Who is this? You know him?
It's me, Jordan. I just want to talk to my girlfriend.
Your girlfriend? I have no idea who you are. Hold on. I'm going to call the authorities.
Mary,
get out of here. Run. And call the police. Jordan, where have you been? What are you doing?
Get back, Brother Nolan, get back!
Jordan, we've got to film for our Christmas video. Let's go!
You know my name?
What?
Brother Nolan! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas, Random Juggle! Merry Christmas, Santa Clara! Merry Christmas, Monica! Merry Christmas, Potter!
Happy New Year to you, too! Expelled! By the way, Brother Azrael is waiting for you in the fireside room.
Jordan. Oh, no, I know. I'm being expelled. Praise the Lord. Merry Christmas.
Jordan, thank goodness you're here. You're not going to believe everybody's here. They all came, Jordan, for you. We heard about your missing $800, and the student body got together. Caleb's here, Mary's here, your family. Gabe's headed, he's on his way. For you, Jordan. They're giving money for you. Go, get up there.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you very much.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you, sis. Thank you. Thank you.
You got money.
My older brother, Jordan Bailey, the richest student in school.
Dear Jordan, remember, no man is a failure who has friends. Thanks for the wings, Clarence.
Thanks, my teacher says,
Wendt,